So it was a short time after this, a man was saved in my church, and his name was Bud Southwick. He later became hunting guide to Brother Branham and myself. He was a dear friend of mine, but he came from the country way up from where we lived. He was a rancher at that time. Gave his heart to Christ. I remember him so vividly coming and kneeling, and his sons coming and kneeling. He had five sons that just knelt right beside him, and he surrendered his life to Christ. Well, because we were, I think, the only people in the town that he was close to, every time he came into the city to sell cattle or do some business, he would stay overnight at our place. One night while he was staying there, I had a visiting minister also speaking at the church. After the service, we were sitting in the front room speaking, and Brother Southwick began to tell me that the government of British Columbia was seeking to give him a hunting territory way far in the north, about, oh, it would be 350, 400 miles north of where we live.
Hey, people. You get back down writing a letter in the first week back at the school you said that you wanted to make another area more or something from the community. I said,
During that 18 months, I resigned the church, my pastorate there in Dawson Creek, and moved all the way south, around 850 miles, to Victoria. It was just 3 weeks after I moved to Victoria that I got a letter from Billy Paul Branham, that's Billy Branham's son, and he said that his father would very much like to come north and go for a rest and perhaps do some hunting in the spring. That would be May of 1961. So they suggested having 3 days meetings in Grand Prairie, Alberta, which was just 75 miles from Dawson Creek, and then 3 meetings in Dawson Creek. Then we would go immediately up north up the Alaskan Highway for a hunt. Once we had the meetings arranged, I met Brother Branham up in Grand Prairie. I think that God has some humor for some of the things that he does. Brother Southwick, who was very well known to me, I had known him for many years. He used to like the odd cigarette. But you know, I never saw him smoke a cigarette in my life. And on this occasion, he got a real desire one day to go and have a cigarette.
You can put my fire going outside to go and read what you're doing. I was going to bring the tent, so I had the fire going outside, and I said, well, I'd rather check the hobbles on the horses. I'm going to go over there with the cows. And so I went down over here and checked them. If you didn't need help, I would check them on the hobbles. I didn't know how to sugar up. And I come back up to the fire and I'm making tea. Well, we went from outside.
We were outside
and out making tea in the fire. We were going inside and he said, he hollered out of tent and he looked at him. He just said, Bud, did you ever smoke? Yeah, I said. And he said, when did you quit? I said, I'm just quit.
Just this minute.
Yeah, good time.
When I told him about those visions and what would happen, coming down the mountain, we shot that caribou on top of the mountain. He said, Brother Branham, according to that vision, we can caribou moss, you know, he sees for miles and miles and then gets the yellow moss. He said, according to what you told me out, that man that's going to have the shirt on, Eddie down there, that checkered shirt, you're going to kill a 9-foot silver-tipped grizzly. I said, that's thus saith the Lord. He said, Brother Branham, I'm not doubting your word, brother. How could I doubt your word? He said, but look, I can see every speck of the ground, and there's nothing in the bush that high. Then the caribou moss, where's the bear at? I said, he's Jehovah Jireh. All I will provide for myself. I said, did you ever hear the story about the squirrels that time? He said, Eddie told me about it. I said, well, he's still God. He says it'll be there. He said, well, Brother Branham, if God told you that this caribou is made exactly what, you ever seen one like it? He said, I don't see how in the world he ever could get 50 yards of it. And said, just exactly what you said. Said, told me, said, my brother was healed just exactly. That's been over a year ago. He's had 3 or 4 fits a day. He's never had one since. He said, how could I doubt it? But said, Brother Branham, I've lived in these mountains all my life. And I've never seen a silver tip in my life. Said, I've seen regular grizzly, but not a silver tip. That's a rare type. I said, but there's one here. So I picked up the head and horns of this wheat cake. I had the rifle and take turns about coming down, having to walk this way down to kill the caribou moss, miles, about 3.5 miles, right down before you can get timber. And so, see, that's not even bear country. That's caribou. So we went down foot by foot. We changed that trophy I was packing. Well, the caribou itself weighed around 900, but we had to leave the meat there, and I just took the cape and the horns alone, weighed about 150 pounds. So here I was trying to pull it down the hill like it's over my shoulders. And when we got within about, we come over a little glacier, and he said, think of it, Brother Ham, we're only about a mile to where I can see with my natural eyes. Well, them horses are standing, and I see every hill. And you're going to kill a 9-foot silver tip grizzly? I said, that's according to the word of God that told me about 3 months ago, and it never failed. I said, you're doubting that, brother. He said, forgive me, Brother Ram. I'm not doubting until my heart is so. I just can't understand it. He said, where's the bear at? I said, I don't know. I said, God's got him sitting around here somewhere. He said, think of a bear that I've never seen. And one that God told you. He said, that's the same God who told you about my brother. I said, absolutely. He said, Brother Ram, put a shell in your gun. About a half a mile. He had been packing, and I had the rifle, so we sat down, rested. He said, Brother Brandon, think, we're only half a mile. I said, but. And I said, he'll be there, don't you worry. Now, I said, but what is that standing right up there, about 2 miles up top of the mountain? He told me back and told me, Brother Brandon, it looks like a mill cow. He said, it's a grizzly bear, so help me. Look at that white grizzles of point, and that sun setting this afternoon. He's a silver tip. I've never seen it before. I said, what are we waiting on? He said, I don't believe if you just shoot him in here, 2 miles away, you'll get him. I said, but sir, according to the vision, I was just right close to him. So tired, worn, we'd done been at least 20 miles that day at Oro Mountain. So then we started right back up again, and I got within about 500 yards, and Bud said, Brother Van, he said, did you ever shoot a silver tip before? I said, I've killed many bears, but never a silver tip. And he said, they're the most vicious of all, so they don't go dying. I said, no bear does. So I said, he said, but the Lord gave you that remedy. I said, oh, yeah. So I had a little 2.7, it's a small rifle. And so then I went on up just a little farther, and he said, Brother Van, don't you think you better shoot him from here? We better not get too close to him. I said, how was that day? The oil was numb. The vision set me right up on him. So we went over there a little coolie, he came up, and when we did, there, my, just set about 250 yards there. I could see his big yellow teeth smacking down like that. It looked like a big haystack, 18 inches between the ears. And he was a mammoth foot about that wide and tall, you know, and he just said, oh, he looks pretty mean. So Bud said, he said, Brother Bram, I tell you where to shoot him. I said, yes, sir. He said, the back, you see. He said, then he can't get up in his feet. I said, but the vision said, shoot him in the heart. He said, when he you get ready to do it that way. First shot, got him. And as we come down, he said, Brother Brennan, we packed them horns, didn't have a measure. He said, them horns look about 90. I said, no, they're just 42. He said, yeah, I told Eddie, I said, watch, the little boy's going to put his hands around there and measure. And when we got down to where the tax was, we couldn't bring the bear head to the next day. You can't get a bear, you can't get a horse near a grizzly bear. You know that, the smell of it, he's gone. We tore up two or three strings trying to get him out. And so then, all he had was mammies laying all over everything to pack. They were scattered them horses and scared to death from the grizzly smell of them. So we went on down, and when we stopped, the boys were there waiting, Eddie and his son. He said, I want to make sure those horns. I pulled back to Eddie. I said, Eddie, watch the boy put his hands around the bottom of the horns, as I told you before we got there. So he goes down, gets out of the tape, out of his little measure. The little boy came around and put his hands on it, and he said, Jackson raised her up like that. He didn't turn and watch the face. He said, Brother Brandon, look in here. Not 1/16 over. Exactly 43 inches on the dime. Jesus never failed. He said, Brother Brandon, we're not going to be a year from today. I said, now, brother, you're just a young convert to Christ. I don't know where you're going to be. I said, I